This is Recount. Recount is a pretty popular damage meter. It shows a lot of different things. Healing. But the two main things that I like about it are the threat module, which is necessary for a tank, of course. And you have to download it separately to get that. And the deaths module as well. Let's pull that up here. So as you can see, we were practicing, looks like Heroic Lich King and an achievement recently. But anyway, the deaths module is very, very handy, especially if you're a raid leader. And it's part of Recount, as I mentioned. So basically, when someone dies, you can pull it up, and it will show you sort of a recap of why they died. You know, what exactly happened to them. So let's look at... we check heals here. So it sort of estimates the current player's health, what heal they had, land, the value, and what time before that player's death. So 6.5 seconds before my death, you know, I got Beacon of Light. I took a little bit of infest damage. Raging Spirit used its shriek on me. So anyway, this is really useful if you're a raid leader and you don't know exactly what happened to someone. You can use this tool. Do note that it's limited to your combat log, so, and it's not always up to date. So a lot of abilities that are sort of just AE effects that aren't direct damage, they won't show up here. So it may just look like someone was full health and they died. So you just kind of have to know the fight, but I highly recommend this. One thing to note is Recount does take a great deal of memory. So if you're one of those people that really worries about that, which you probably shouldn't, but if you worry about this number, how much add-ons are taking, then Recount is not for you. I use it because, as I said, I can use the threat module as part of it, so I don't have to use a damage meter and a separate threat meter. So to the right of that, you can't really see them, but if I go ahead and start attacking, you can see sort of scrolling damage here. And this is a mod called Mixed Scrolling Battle Text. So if I do MSBT, I can pull that up. And this is just basically a modified scrolling combat text add-on. I really like it though. You can customize it a great deal. And so I found that I wanted that information, but I didn't need it sort of precedent on my screen. A lot of people will stick it, you know, right here on the right or left, right under their character. And it's really a bad practice because you're just wasting all this game screen state with these useless numbers that most of the time you're not going to pay attention to. You know, you may like seeing the big crits, but in reality it doesn't really matter. You know you're hitting your buttons, you know you're doing your rotation properly. So you only really need that information on your screen to glance at or to look back at later. So to that end, I set it up sort of, so there's three different areas. If you can go to the configure scroll areas, it'll show you the outline of those. So basically you can see this is outgoing damage. When I do deal damage, it shows up here. And you can kind of see the yellow hits for special attacks, and it'll show the icon. Incoming damage, you'll see that in a raid video probably, but that's here, and then heals go here. And usually these would sort of be scrolling throughout. And then the final thing to the right is a hidden hotkey bar. This is part of Domino's. And this is basically just sort of raid consumables and things I'll use in the middle of the raid that I want quick access to, but I don't need to see the actual bar the whole time. So if you open up Domino's and configure your bars, you can right click on a bar and set the faded opacity to 0, and then that basically does exactly what you can see here, where it's completely faded until you mouse over and it will show up. So next up, this right here is power auras. This particular indicator is something I just set up a long time ago and I got used to, but this just indicates to me that one of my shouts is not up. So if I go ahead and hit shout, now I have battle shout and the indicator goes away. And if I do commanding shout, it will also go away, showing me that I have one of my shouts. If I get rid of it, it comes back up. So I'll show you Power Auras here. This is one of the most useful add-ons I've found. / Powa, P-O-W-A. And I have a lot of things set up here, but the basic idea is you can create, if I go to edit, you can create fairly custom indicators based on a number of events. So activation by, this one's a buff. As you can see, I just entered a partial name called Shout. So that way it will check for both Battle Shout and Commanding Shout. And if one is active, then I'm okay. And there's a lot of flags you can have it check. So I only want it to check when I'm in combat. So if I get rid of Shout right now, I'm not in combat, so but it's still not showing me the indicator. But as soon as I start attacking, oops, I have to close this. As soon as I start attacking, then it shows up. And once I get out of combat, in a moment here, it goes away. So highly recommended. If you have any sort of indicators you want to watch for, you can also use it in raid situations. So let's see. You won't be able to see it, of course, but this is one I set up for Sarfang. So basically, I set my focus to our off tank in that fight, and then because it's checked on focus, and the debuff activation is called Rune of Blood. Whenever he gets Rune of Blood, I will get this warning. You know, it tells me to taunt. You can also have it play sounds, so I have a particular sound set up here, and things like that. So another very useful add-on for raiding. I also have one for Sword and Board. This one also shows the actual timer left on using the buff. So if I attack here for a while, let me get that to proc. There it is. So when Sword and Board procs, you can see it pops up an icon there. And if I use it, then it goes away. Pretty simple.